Hi programmers, I want to run you through a couple of macros that'll help you to copy a line within an effect or to a second effect. I'll show you the macros and then I'll also take you through the command line syntax. It does the same thing. That way you have a choice of either using the macro or keying it in. I'm Kat and I make training videos. If you've got a tutorial request, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to be notified of when I've got a new video up, just subscribe. So, why would you want to copy effect lines? Well, maybe you've got a second group of lights that you want to add to an existing effect and be able to tweak without affecting the original selection of lights. And it could be something as simple as maybe just changing the direction. Or maybe you have two different quantities of lights, but you want the effect waveform to complete in the same amount of time over both. In that case, you'd also want the groups to be separated into their own lines. Or maybe you just want to copy an effect line and not have to do it manually. First up, let's look at a macro that copies lines within the same effect. That's going to be this macro right here. Let's run it first to see what it does, and then we'll open up the macro and see inside. I've got this effect here. Let me edit it. Okay, say I want to copy this first line to a second line. I'll hit the macro and first tell it what effect number this is. Then it's asking me which line I want to copy, because if my effect has multiple lines, I'd want to be able to be specific. And then, which line do I want to copy to? I'm going to say line 2. And there it is. I'm now going to update the fixture selection for the second line to a new group of fixtures. The flexibility of being able to say where I want my line to copy to means that I can also use the macro to replace existing lines with a copy of another if I need to. If you want to copy multiple lines, you can do that too. So now let's take a look at what this macro looks like. The first three lines are to set our variables, those pop-ups asking us to pick which effect we're working on and what line to copy from and to. The last line executes a command based on the variables that we keyed in. If you prefer to use the command line syntax and skip this macro entirely, you absolutely can. You just be typing something like copy effect 1.x.y at 1.x.z, please. X is the effect ID, Y is the line you're copying from, and Z is the line that you're copying to. And that's really what our macro is doing. Once that effect line is copied, you can edit it however you want, like changing the fixture selection or editing any of these cells. So that macro was specific to copying lines within the same effect. If you want to copy a line from one effect to another, I've got a second macro. Let's say we want to copy the first line from effect 418 to the second line of effect 417. Hit the macro, and first we enter the number of the effect that we're copying from. Next is the line number that we want to copy, which is 1. Now I'll enter the number of the effect in the pool I'm copying it to, and then the destination line. And if I edit that second effect, I can see that line I just copied. Taking a look at this macro, it's the same idea as the first one where we've got lines asking us to import our variables, and then the final line runs our syntax. Again, to run this as a command line instead of a macro, I'd be typing copy effect 1.a.b at 1.c.d, please, remembering that a is the ID of the effect I'm copying from, b is the line of the effect that I wish to copy, C is the ID of the effect I'm copying to, and D is the destination line within that effect. I know that we're all building a lot of effects most of the time, so I hope these little shortcuts help you save some time. Thanks for watching. See you soon.